Her son killed her husband. Now she's going to prison. New developments today in the Elkhorn murder plot and Teresa Carson's punishment for covering up her husband's death. KATV News Watch 7's Carol Kloss is live at the courthouse.
This murder was fueled by a love triangle between a father, his son, and their shared girlfriend. Today, the judge sentenced the victim's wife to 18 to 20 years in prison for her role in this crime. That's almost the maximum sentence. Cuffed and let off by security officers, Teresa Carson begins her prison term. She is one of eight people allegedly involved in the brutal beating death of her husband, Brian Carson. Prosecutors say last April, Brian Carson's son, Ryan, beat his dad in a rage after Ryan caught his father having an affair with his girlfriend, Nicole Walker. Prosecutors say Teresa Carson knew of the planned murder and lured her husband to their Elkhorn home. Carson says she was protecting her kids, not plotting her husband's murder. Her lawyer says Brian Carson was an alcoholic who abused his family.
Said in court, everybody's downplayed the fact that this Brian was a monster. I mean, he was drunk all the time. He beat my client. He beat Ryan.
You know, there's a lot of factors, I'm sure, that the judge looked at, including experience, age, sophistication, and knowledge of what was going on here.
Now, the Douglas County attorney says Teresa Carson was the only mature adult involved in this crime, and she should have known better. Klein says Teresa Carson was also motivated by her husband's six-figure life insurance policy. She denies that motive. And Teresa and Brian's son, Ryan, pleaded guilty to second-degree murder yesterday. He faces life in prison. Daughter Sarah has also admitted her role in the plot and is going through the juvenile court system.
And Carol, what about the girlfriend, Nicole Walker?
Well, the judge sentenced Nicole last week to 4 to 5 years in prison, and she did give birth to a little girl in jail. Paternity tests are being done to determine the father, either the victim or his son, the killer.
Carol Kloss reporting live. Thanks, Carol. Another suspect in Brian Carson's murder, Jeffrey Hill, told the judge today he made a stupid mistake. Prosecutors say Hill helped get rid of the body and clean up the crime scene. They add he cooperated with police from the beginning and was willing to testify against the others. The judge sentenced Hill to 4 to 5 years in prison. With good behavior, he could be released in 2.5 years. The cases against two other defendants, Ryan King and Colton Novosconi, will be heard in February.